Hello, David Clarke here from DVC Training. I'm just going to do a quick video on something new I noticed I can do in EDIUS 11, which is to export multiple timelines very, very quickly. Now, in EDIUS for ages, we've been able to do batch encoding, which is where you would bring up the batch export and then you would add in timelines one at a time, click the button and then export them. That's been in EDIUS for donkey's years. In EDIUS 10, they added the job monitor. So you've done an edit, you could then print a file, it would go in the job monitor and you could carry on working. I'm not talking about either of those. What I'm talking about is just being able to select a whole bunch of timelines at once and choose to make them all into individual movies. And I'm doing this through the new version of Mync rather than EDIUS. So here we have an edit. We can see I've got a bunch of different timelines. If you look in the bin, most of them are in a timelines bin. Some of them aren't. But I've got a bunch of different timelines and I literally just put color bars on them just for the purposes of this, because it doesn't really matter what I'm exporting. I'm going to bring up Mync. In the management tab, you'll notice that you can see projects. You never used to be able to see individual EDIUS projects. They get put in there automatically by EDIUS as you're editing. So I haven't put any of these in here. It's just as I've been editing, it puts them in there. My project is called Multiple Timelines. If I go to that and open it up, you can see I've got the different bins that I had in there. And in this bin, I've got three timelines. Well, one of the things you can do inside of Mync is to transcode clips, which is obviously convert it from one file to the other. And that applies to timelines. So in this case, I could just select all of those three, right click and say transcode, choose the settings and go OK. And now Mync will take those three timelines and make them up into video files. Pops into the job monitor, you can see it being done. Right, so there we go. Oh, it's already done extras. Take the job types and turn off the waveform cache. Put it down to just displaying the last day so I can see it a bit better. But there we are. It has done those three timelines. Right click, open in Explorer. There are my timelines, made up as MP4 files. And the simple thing I'm showing off is the fact that I can just see timelines, select a whole bunch of them and say make something out of it. It's quicker than being inside of EDIUS and doing that, print to file, add, print to file, add, print to file, add. I mean, you can speed things up a lot inside of EDIUS 10 because I can add extra buttons on the timeline up here. So for example, I could add in a button on the recorder side which says print to file with the default exporter. And then if I go into print to file and I set a default exporter, like for example, let's go to H.264 and choose say that one and say save as default number one. Because I've got that button there now, I can go and click on that button and it will go straight off to the job monitor. Up to now, I could have done that with just a couple of clicks. But the new thing is I don't even have to do that. I can literally go to Mync, select them, right click, transcode, bosh, it gets on with it. When you do that, you don't get to any of the settings. So if you go to another timeline like this one, right click, transcode. I only have a few basic settings in here. And when I chose this MP4 file, it didn't set any MP4 settings, any bit rates or anything like that for me. You have to set that up first. If you want to change settings or anything, just do it the normal way, because you get into print file. This is just a quick way of doing lots of timelines. I can see it for my tutorials where I've got 20 timelines I want to do. They all have the same settings. Literally select them all in here, bong, get on with it. And it just saves an awful lot of clicking inside of EDIUS. What can I configure about this? Well, obviously the question is how do you get presets in and where's it going? Because here you'd expect that you would click a browse button or something and it would change the destination. Nope, I can't do that here. It's putting the file names in automatically based on what they're actually called, which is exactly what I wanted to do. And how do you change these settings? Okay, first thing, the destination. It's very simple. Go up to settings, import and transcode. And here you can see that I can choose the destination that I want to go to. So click on that. I can put it to any particular folder. That's where all my edits are now going to get transcoded to. So you don't change it in the transcode box, you change it in the settings. Down here you can see my presets for what kind of files I can make, and there aren't many of them, but you can add something in. So you click on this and you add in something. Your obvious question is, where do I get the thing I'm adding in? To get the thing you're adding in, go back into EDIUS, go to print to file, and choose a type of file. So imagine I wanted to make Grass Valley lossless files. What I could do is click on that and select it and then say save as preset. And I could call this something. So that's now saved me a preset. Now to get that into Mync, what I do is come down here and say export preset, stick it somewhere, make sure you know where you're putting it, then come back into Mync, select, find that thing you've just saved, click on add, and now I've got that preset in there. If I wanted specific MP4 settings, then I would like choose MP4. Let's turn off enable conversion. Start with that, but I'm going to say save a preset, put in some settings. So let's do it all at 9 average, 15 large, super fine, 192 on the sound. Yep, export it. And then again, go back to Mync and select Bosch, add. Yep, there we are. I have now got my lossless and that in there. I can now come back to my timelines, say transcode, and choose one of those. And it's going to make for me an MP4 with those exact settings. I didn't even have to come to Mync. I could have been inside of EDIUS, gone to the Mync tab, dragged a box over what I wanted to export, right-click, transcode, choose one of these settings. Now, these settings I would have had to add in Mync, go OK, and it gets on with it. So I can do it either in Mync or inside the Mync tab in EDIUS. The only thing I can't do in the Mync tab is to add in those transcoding presets. Come back into Mync and you can see in the job monitor in Mync, it's actually done that stuff. Right click, open in Explorer. There we are. All my different stuff. As an aside, and this is nothing to do with EDIUS 11, you'll notice I double clicked on this AVI file, which is the Grass Valley format, and it played for me in a media player. That might not happen to you. If, for example, I was to open this with Films and TV, which is the default Windows thing, it doesn't play back. And that's nothing to do with EDIUS 11. That's just a thing about Windows not necessarily understanding the Grass Valley codec. Just about everything will play back in MP4. Only some things play back these Grass Valley codecs. And with EDIUS 10 and with EDIUS 11, it doesn't, as a default, play back Grass Valley codecs in anything apart from EDIUS. And actually Resolve understands it, but pretty much nothing else does. To actually get these things playing back, you need to add in a Grass Valley codec, which is an extra download that you can get from Grass Valley, which is free, and then it'll let most programs play it back. Still doesn't let Films and TV play it back, but I don't like Films and TV anyway. I think it's rubbish. I always use VLC, or I put this thing on, Media Player Classic. But that's nothing to do with what I'm trying to show you, which is basically, oh, I can suddenly do an awful lot of transcoding of stuff in my projects at once, nice and quickly. Obviously, if I wanted to make that timeline as well, which is in a different bin, well, I can always just select those three and add it and then go to that bin. Or inside of EDIUS, just shove them all in the same bin. You know, take that timeline, put it in there. Now, I've got four in that bin. If you go to Mync, they're all in there and I could have done them all at once. If I've got lots of bins in my project, sometimes timelines end up in weird bins that I don't want them to, because when I click the new timeline button, I'm not even looking where they've gone and they've gone somewhere strange. So what I do is I set up a search bin inside of EDIUS with all my timelines. Now to do that, you just come up to here, open up the search, and here it says, okay, where are you going to look? Now as a default, it looks in the root and I want to look in everything. So I get rid of that completely. Now it's going to look in everything. Then I say, right, let's look for clip type and type sequence and search. And it makes me up a search bin with all the timelines in. Doesn't matter where they are in the project, they're all in one place. If I wanted to put them all in one place, I could just select them all and shove them into, say, a timelines bin, and now they'll all be in there. Inside of Mync, oh, that search bin is there. So I can select all of them, even if they're not in the same bins, and right-click and say transcode, and it'll do it for me. That's one of the advantages we've got of Mync being more integrated into EDIUS. And no doubt there will be more that come across as EDIUS 11 developed. You couldn't do this in EDIUS 10. This is something specific to EDIUS 11 because they've integrated Mync into EDIUS a lot more than they used to. If you've got EDIUS 9 and you're thinking of going to EDIUS 11, the offer to get a free EDIUS 11 when you buy EDIUS X is still going. It was going to end at the end of October. It's going to end in a few days' time. But if you have got EDIUS 9, then you could order EDIUS 11 right now and get it slightly cheaper, because you'd basically pay for the EDIUS 9 to EDIUS 10 upgrade and get EDIUS 11 free. After this period ends, you will end up paying for a jump grade from EDIUS 9 to EDIUS 11, and it'll be a little bit more expensive. Just sort of throw that in, but you've only got a few days to act on that, so if you're thinking about it, it might be worth doing it now. Anyway, hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to like and subscribe. course, visit my website, www.dvctraining.co.uk, for more information on EDIUS or to order the upgrades. And I'll see you next time.